Hello, my son Ka. My name is Sai Zompa.
Jama Shun Lamaze. My name is Aung Cho Win. Recently, we just spent about 6 months riding motorcycles from Myanmar to UK and back. It took us about 50,000 kilometers across 46 countries.
We just came back last November, and during that 6 months, I can't believe it was a very big adventure for us. And I can't believe we did it together, man.
Sai and I have known each other for almost 20 years. We have been riding short motorcycle trips in Myanmar as well as neighboring country. But an overland journey this big has always been a dream for us, a biker's dream. We're also trying to recreate history inspired by Ubado and Dr. Nisain, who did the similar trips in the 50s with the BSA. We name our journey Motologues, as it is all about motorcycle, touring, and dialogue.
We did a lot of preparation for this trip. We planned our route, we planned the countries that we want to visit and the places that we wanted to go. We even planned our camping gear, mechanical stuff, and also our fitness. We also planned on attending on the motorcycle workshop because just in case our motorbike broke down. On the 26th of May last year, we started this big adventure with him, of course, and I can't believe we did it together.
Being on the road every day riding for 6 months, we enjoy seeing other countries' environment, infrastructures, and facilities. Paved roads and bridges connected seas and mountains, ships and trains transported us and our bike from one country to another. What will have been a one full day ride from Estonia to Finland via Russia took us only 2 hours by ship. Crossing the world-famous Øresund Bridge, which connects Scandinavian to Europe continent, took us only 50 minutes, pretty much the same time that most of us spent this morning on Stanley Bridge, which is 10 times lesser in distance. Our six-month journey was truly an eye-opener. We got to enjoy and experience landscapes, villages, and meet the nicest people that one would not be able to if you were flying. Though we enjoy visiting man-made structures, sites, famous sites, we are more impressed by the nature that surrounds us as we pass by. The beauty of riding the motorcycle is you are not only enjoying the view, fantastic view, but also able to feel, smell, and touch the environment as we pass by. We can smell the earthy, fruity vines of Bordeaux in France. We were really soaking wet as we were crossing the Siberian highway in Russia. We can't forget the wild rosemary fields of Gobi Desert in Mongolia, nor the sharp wind and icy weather that accompany us in Norway while we are on the way to Nordkap. But how we wish we can forget the violent smell of a septic truck which leaked its discharge pipe right in front of us while we were crossing in Russia. I don't think the driver did it on purpose. Yeah,
yeah. So they know two Myanmar guys following them.
So we feel more in touch with the nature while we are on the road with our motorcycles.
We want to admit that we have some preconceived stereotype ideas about certain countries, including Russia, Pakistan, and Iran. We are quite worried that if we need to cross those countries. After this trip, we realized that we can't believe everything what we see on the news or even in media. When we were in Russia, we thought like something like in the movie, we would see like mafia, gangster, you know, all sort of bad things, even the rude people or bad drivers. But in fact, if you ask us what is our favorite country is, Russia will be the number one, of course, apart from Myanmar. And Thank you. So, Iran is also another pleasant surprise for us. In Iran, people were so nice, and the petrol was so cheap. I think it's even cheaper than a bottle of water. But ironically, we run out of petrol in the middle of the desert under the scorching sun. So we tried to stop many drivers, and this man with a car with zero knowledge of English stopped by and gave us some of his petrol. And he even followed us all the way to another town, just in case we run out of petrol again. So in return for his kindness, we tried to offer some money, but he refused. So instead, we invited him for the dinner and drink. We exchanged smile and hand gesture instead of words. This became the most memorable moment in our big adventures. After going on this trip, we also realized how kindness people is. People were so kind, so helpful, and so curious for our adventures. But on the other hand, we also want to promote our Myanmar a little bit. Knowing that our Myanmar doesn't have a very good news outside, basically outside over those who war. So whenever we have a chance, we try to exchange our stories, our country stories, and also the pictures of beautiful people. Yeah. So, in fact, these two persons, they are from New Zealand. Diggy and Diana will visit us sometime this year to us. And this is how we promote it ourselves.
We are also really grateful for the support and help of our family, friends, and loved ones, as well as Myanmar people here and abroad. It is really heartwarming that Myanmar people all over the world, whom we have never ever met before this trip, have invited to their home, opened their doors, and show us around the cities. We are also warmly invited to the home of overland riders, whom we briefly met over coffee breaks or fewer stops, but ended up spending nights at their home for wine, home-cooked food, and clean, warm beds.
After spending 6 months on motorbike, we realized we don't really need much in our life. We learned this lesson by when our motorcycle can carry as much. You can imagine how much we've been carrying on this. We were carrying so much in fears of what if. We even carry luxury items like padded floor mats, folding chairs, and also even a coffee maker. So, all these things are pulling us down, and along the way, we throw some of them and we give some stuff to other people. So instead of having 6 t-shirts, it became 3 t-shirts. Of course, we are more smellier than when we left from Myanmar. Yeah. We were trying to minimize our luggage so that we can maximize our experience.
Self-discipline played a very important role in our journey. We have to be really careful of what we eat, as we don't want unnecessary trips that jeopardize our trip. And we have to make sure we have enough rest every day. We have to follow a schedule of when to set off and when to stop, as we don't want to end up in the middle of nowhere when the sun goes down.
One can never be prepared enough. If we waited for the perfect moment, I don't think we will be standing here and talking about all this trip again. In fact, if you really want to do it, just risk yourself and go for it. If the plan doesn't go as how you plan it, you just have to make use of the whole situation instead. These are some of the pictures that we didn't plan. This is in Mongolia. This is in Mongolia. Someone was having fun when I was having a trouble. Yeah. Yeah. And this is in India. And this is in China, where we cannot ride motorbike on the expressway. We get caught by the police and we are forced to ride on this one. And we didn't manage to reach to another town, and this is very late evening in the Gobi Desert in Mongolia. And this is the view that we have. So, ideally, our return trip was to ship our bike through from Turkey to India to shorten our trip. And of course, we also quite worried about Iran and Pakistan. But after realizing so much paperwork that we have to go through and the cost of the shipping was so expensive, we decided to ride through Iran and Pakistan. So without this long detour, I don't think we will ever meet all these beautiful people in those countries.
A very close biker friend of us suddenly passed away in October 2018. Before his passing, we had plans to go several motorcycle trips with him, as well as a group of other friends. So his passing has served as a wake-up call for us to drop everything, arrange everything, and embark on this journey, which turned out to be the most epic journey of our life. I actually bought one of his motorcycles from his parents and used it for this journey. One of the most memorable highlights of this journey was while we were in Norway. We went to a very specific location in a very small, tiny fishing village just to try to replicate a photo that he took while he was there just 2 weeks before his passing. So this is Goh Zau Liang in the middle. And can we have a round of applause for leaving such a memory? Thank you so much. So being on the road riding every day from one place to another made us realize that we have to live at the very moment. We pass by so many amazing, tremendous, breathtaking views, heaven on earth sceneries, but only for a few seconds. We received genuine help from strangers that we may never see again in our life, and we have to move on with our journey. So this has taught us to live at the moment and enjoy being at the present, whether is it good or bad, rain or shine.
The idea of Motorlog is to push ourselves to get out of our comfort zone and learn along the way. Of course, to inspire our younger generations and also promote Myanmar in our own way. Once you set your mind into it, you will achieve your goal. You just need determination, passion, and a little bit of craziness. Yeah. There will be many directions and roads, and you may even get lost along the way. But don't worry, don't stop chasing, don't stop riding, or in our case, we're not stop riding. All the twists and turns will lead to the same destination. You just have to enjoy the ride. Thank you so much.